Hello friends, do you prepare a prosperity basket on New Year's Eve? I do. I grew up in the Philippines, where there's a lot of religious and superstitious beliefs. One of this is the prosperity basket which we prepare before we welcome the new year. I have made several videos about this in recent years. Some have fruits in their prosperity basket. Some have lucky symbols. And some have the traditional prosperity basket. But in this video, I am going to share to you a budget prosperity bowl that you can make from the things you already have at home. Are you interested? Please continue watching. Hello friends, welcome to Ophiria Online, the channel that will make you wealthy, healthy, happy, pretty, and debt-free. Yes, you heard it right. Here in my channel, you will learn to do all of these things. And how you do that will be revealed in my videos. But the question is, do you believe in feng shui? I do. At first, I was so skeptical, because I am a Christian, but now, I really believe in its magic. God said, "Help yourself, and I will help you," and that's what I did. But before I continue, please remember to click the subscribe button below and share this video to your friends. I always have feng shui tip like this one coming out on my channel. If you don't want to miss any tip, then go ahead and ring the bell to be notified each time I post. Thank you very much. Now, if you want to learn and are interested in feng shui, please watch until the end of this video. First, we need a round bowl, of course. It could be made of ceramic, metal, wood, or glass like I have here. I couldn't find a bigger bowl, I have another one, but it's too big, so I will have this instead. Then we get the cotton. I only have cotton balls at home, so I can take 12 pieces, that represents the 12 months. The cotton symbolizes itself, easy flow of wealth into the house. We can easily solve our problems that may come in 2023. Then we'll have some rice. You may want to use the sticky or glutinous rice, if you have, which symbolizes a strong bond with the family members, with our co-workers, friends, relatives, and everybody around us. I live in the countryside, so I don't have time to go to the big cities now to buy glutinous rice, so I use the usual rice. It's okay. The rice symbolizes abundance, good harvest like in business, in our works, good grades in school, and in all things you do. Then I'll take 12 pieces of eggs that represent the 12 months. The meaning of eggs in feng shui is a new beginning. The overall form means harmony, safety, and a smooth path towards achieving goals. I only have oranges at home right now, and they are in fact too big in my bowl, but remember, this is a budget prosperity bowl, so we don't need to go to the market specially to buy what we need. If you have clementines, it is better. The orange is a symbol of abundance and fortune in feng shui. It is believed to have the property to draw lots of prosperity, abundance, and wealth luck energies. Then let's include 8 pieces of bay leaves. 8 means infinity in feng shui, unending prosperity. Bay leaf is considered auspicious with numerous properties, and have been used for such purposes for centuries now. In fact, not only feng shui but many other value systems also talk about the benefits of using bay leaves, and has shared protocols for using bay leaves for various purposes. It is said to attract wealth, love, for protection and cleansing. Here are ordinary stones you can find outside your garden or anywhere. It represents the earth element. Of course, I already washed and sterilized them. I took 12 pieces to represent the 12 months. You can also paint them with gold if you wish to further boost your luck in 2023. You will shine in all aspects, such as your career, business, studies, or anything. Then we need some sweets. If you have that chocolate coins, then put 12 pieces in your bowl. I only have these candies, it's the M&M with peanut in it. You'll see, peanut is also a lucky symbol in feng shui. It symbolizes growth and is a feng shui symbol for abundance and for wealth. I have chosen the green and yellow colors. We'll see what I will decide later when arranging my prosperity bowl. We need sweets in our prosperity bowl to attract sweetness in our relationships with our loved ones. In all prosperity baskets that I have prepared through the years, they always contain 8 pieces of Chinese coins. They are said to symbolize prosperity, abundance, and good fortune. It is sometimes called emperor's coins. It is often made of copper. The Chinese coin itself has an interesting design and depiction. Because it is round, with a square-shaped hole in the center, it is said to be a representation of earth surrounded by heaven. It is for this reason that, when utilized by humans, they are an emblem of the harmony of the heaven-earth man. The coin has 2 sides. The yang side, which boasts the 4 Chinese signs of the emperor's reign. And the yin side, which features 2 ancient characters. Then we need 8 pieces of paper money. Remember 8. Unending prosperity. It doesn't matter about the denomination. If you have $1 bills, take it. Just be sure to have the same banknotes as if you have $5 bills, take 8 pieces, or if you have $20 bills, take whatever you have. You can even have coins if that's what you have. Just be sure to have 8 similar pieces. I rolled my banknotes like this. And tie them with red ribbon. You can use whatever thread you have. I mean red thread. In this prosperity bowl, I am going to include 2 pieces of dice. They are recognized as a symbol of chance and luck all around the globe. So if you are aiming to win big, include this in your prosperity bowl. Now let's start to assemble the prosperity bowl. We use the cotton for a very good foundation of our wealth by having the wood element on the base of our prosperity bowl. Next are the stones, which also represents the wood element in feng shui. Then the rice. Remember, we take anything we have at home. I don't have sticky rice now, so I'll be glad to use this standard table rice. Fill the bowl with rice, and leave about 5 centimeters on top for other materials that we will have in it. Then arrange the eggs in a circle. I decided to use the yellow candies and arrange them in between the eggs. And spread the 8 pieces of bay leaf in the middle. And arrange the Chinese coins with the yang side facing up. Now, I arrange my art pieces, rolled up paper bills for unending prosperity throughout the year. Let's see now if I still have space for the 12 pieces of oranges. That attracts wealth and prosperity for the coming 12 months. And of course the dice. I have chosen to have two of them to double the luck. Now, for this bonus video, I am going to share to you something very powerful to do before welcoming the new year. Remember, this is just something I have done for myself to attract more wealth and abundance. And of course mix it with prayers and belief in God, as well as hard work and perseverance, and I promise you, nothing is impossible. You are the creator of your reality. It's still up to you to believe it or not. You don't need to listen to me if you don't believe it. And you don't need to comment negatively either. In this lucky charm, we need cotton. Unpow red envelope. If you don't have unpow, you can make your own using a red sheet of paper. And 8,888 of your currency, or any amount you have. The most important is that you have the 8,888, or even more if you have. In my envelope, I am going to have 8,888 Swedish crowns. I have 5 banknotes at 1,000 crowns. Then 6 banknotes at 500 crowns. Another one at 500 crowns. One at 200 crowns. One piece of 100 crowns. Another piece of 50 crowns. And one piece of 20 crowns plus a total of 8 crowns in coins. That would make a total of 8,888. Now we put all together in the red envelope. First the cotton. And the paper bills, arranged according to the denominator, with the lowest in front, with the face up. The face should be visible immediately when you take out the money. Lastly, the coins. Seal it and put it in your pocket on New Year's Eve. You must have in your pocket in 9 days. If you change pants, don't forget to transfer the unpow to the new pants. Don't ever let the unpow be on the floor so that it won't be able to absorb negative energy. You may put it in your wallet if you don't have a pocket. But remember to have it there until the 9th day. You may want to put the money in your piggy bank, or why not deposit them in the bank after having them in 9 days. If you like, or want to learn other kinds of lucky rituals, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for watching. That's all for now, my friends. See you on my next video. Please continue watching. Before I end this video, I just want to remind you once again that we have all the lucky charms and feng shui cures to help you attract money and abundance, and even happiness. Please visit our online store. The link is on the description below. Remember, I am here to guide you and share to you the things I know, not just for the money. I'll tell you the right charm to have, even if you want the most expensive one. If I think it is not suitable for you, then I'll let you know. I want you to have the right protection, the right charm or amulet that brings you good luck and good fortune. If you buy the wrong one, you are only wasting your money. The only thing I want to know when you seek advice from me is your exact date of birth. Your Gregorian zodiac sign doesn't mean anything in feng shui. It is also important to note that planting good thoughts right from the beginning is very important for feng shui enhancers and cures to work wonders. Enhancers and cures should be bought with a generous heart. Most who are buying feng shui products without genuine intention or generosity will not enjoy the benefits from the items they obtained. If you are stingy or not willing to spend that kind of money, then you should not buy the item. Generosity simply means willingness to obtain the item with your own money happily. Do not be greedy, and never try to obtain a feng shui item through unscrupulous means. Such motive is considered a bad sin, which is considered as bad intention right from the start. This simply means programming bad energy into your items. Take note that if you have doubts right from the beginning about an item meeting your own expectations, then you should not get it from the start. You are the master of your own life. No one is forcing you to buy anything. It is a common practice that the Chinese would normally buy their feng shui items with a willing heart and refrain from doubting, condemning, judging, and challenging if they are well aware about the consequences of backfire. Remember, once you have negative thoughts, you are actually programming negative energies into your items, and they will go against the intended motive. Peace, love, and blessings to all. I wish everybody good luck, good health, and good fortune. May we have more blessings in life. That's all for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you find it useful and share it with your friends. If you want to know more about feng shui, please subscribe to my channel and get good feng shui in your life. See you on my next video. Goodbye.